we're going to be testing a couple of snow foams, and we've got one on each end of the scale today, haven't we? We've got this
Bilt Hamber Auto Foam, which is a alkaline based cleaner.
Yeah, and then we've got
pH neutral, which is goes away from it being a strong alkaline or like an acid based cleaner. So it is pH balanced. And yeah, there's a little bit more science behind this and how it cleans.
Yeah, that's what we were going to say. Because we had this question about if you diluted that down to be a pH 7 also, which one would clean the better?
Yeah, and speaking with Valet Pro and getting some more technical information, there's a lot more science happening behind the scenes with this than there is where you're just going for just pure strength.
Exactly. So what we summed up is that's cleaning based on pH scale.
Yep.
And literally just that chemical in quite a basic way, pH 14 chemical, which is going to strip dirt and grime.
Yeah.
Whereas this is pH 7, so it's not as caustic like that. It's pH balanced, but there's a lot more active ingredients in, and like I said, science about lifting dirt.
And penetrating through. It's attracted to the surface of the paint, so drawing itself through the dirt and softening it in that manner.
So, first things first, shall we? We've got a little litmus paper test here, old school. Shall we pour 100 mils of each into one of these little beakers and do a test as they come out of the bottle?
Yeah.
And see what they are.
See what level we're
at. Yeah. I'll do this one, you do that one. I've given you easy job, EC, because look at the size of this bottle.
It's got a charred lock on it, though.
I'll see if we can get 100 mil. Oh, and it would be windy. So 10 mil we're going. It's pretty much bang on.
Yeah.
So this is before we dilute it. We're just going to get a little strip each.
Thank you. Your fingers off that. I've already shown how strong that is.
Oh God, it has. So yeah, a little bit of residue off the lid. And I've already turned it bright blue. So yeah, you can see straight away this one, bright blue. Which when you look at the scale, definitely 12. Maybe even 13.
How would you say yours? pH neutral. I'd say it's happily on a 6 there.
6, I'd say, yeah. Not 7, but definitely 6. So far, they're doing what they say on the tin. This is 14, and that is 6. So, shall we dilute it?
Put some water in.
Yeah. So, water's pH 7. So, in theory, it will dilute them both down.
It will, yeah.
It's not quite as simple as that. To get this to pH 7, you'd have to dilute it with thousands and thousands of litres of water. I'm sure someone will be able to do the maths, so if you can, comment below and put in the equation. But for now, I don't think it's going to change the pH much, but let's just top it up. I'm still at 12.
And yeah, it's still not moved, has it? That's still 6, I'd say. Yeah.
So a 10 to 1 dilution, which is roughly, I mean, you can, when you do your snow foam, I don't know about you, but in real world, I don't get a beaker and measure mil per mil.
No, people lose, I think they lose, when they're working out flow rates and how many litres per minute, it's, granted, you could get it exactly, but you've got to be in the real world, where you're getting out, you're cleaning your car, you know, about an inch in the bottom, you can always adjust on the actual foam gun anyway, is usually a relatively good starting point. Yeah. You can get more
inch on bottom, in a litre bottle, top up with water, boom, ready to go.
Exactly.
Shall we use it? Shall we give them both a go and see how we get on with it?
Yeah, do a 50-50, see which one.
Like, we both expect different things from a foam, we were just saying, didn't we?
Yeah.
Where I prefer to get like as close to a touchless clean as possible. And I don't want to damage the coating, so I'd probably tend to go for that one because I want something strong that I can use quite neat without damaging the coating. Whereas you are quite happy to...
I just want to soften dirt. I'm not too fussed about it. I don't want a touchless clean. I just want that dirt broken down so you've got a sludge so when you come to the contact wash, there's no risk of that interfering and damaging the paint. Yeah. I don't care what the paint looks like at that stage. It's having that contact wash. So yeah, I'm not too fussed, and that's why pH neutral and still being
Still both siding on this one, but this gets a lot of reviews, doesn't it?
Yeah, people love it, and it is a great snow foam, but it's that whole where do you go? Do you go for strength, and what impact's that going to have on your LSPs?
Yeah,
or is it going for something a bit more focused towards getting the most out of whatever product you've got on there? and it lasts longer. You do get a lot of people when they're using it, say how much of a great cleaner auto foam is,
yeah,
but then questioning the product they had on there, and sometimes that product gets blamed for not being durable when in fact it is the products you're maintaining it with.
Well, that's the thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Even like the toughest ceramic coatings, you're still going to degrade them.
Yeah.
If you're using something really caustic. Or
yeah, absolutely. Really, yeah, it's going to take longer, but you're going to slowly. And then the other things that get missed, like trim, for instance,
yeah,
you know, black plastics, things like that, are going to be affected by,
yeah, like on a lot of cars. When,
yeah,
you,
your
like
rubbers
that,
all that will dry. Yeah. You'll start to dry them out. Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's the other side
but
of it.
I think
really,
that a lot of the good reviews on this come from the dilution ratios, which are crazy, aren't they? So
they
dilution is it 1 to 100 on this?
It's higher than that.
It's 1 to 5,
I don't know if it's on there, but it has got some crazy high dilution ratios.
Yeah, I know it's over 1 to 100. Whereas that's more like your 1 to 25.
Yeah, So. On paper, and you're not like face value, it's like it's making that sound like, you know, it's slightly cheaper by about, yeah, £4 or £5, and it's like, yeah, no brainer, go with that.
Yeah, yeah.
But then when you look to the science behind it, that's when they start differing.
Yeah, I get it. Right, I'm interested to get them in a foam lance.
Get them tested.
Here's two we made earlier.
Yep.
So let's, like I say, you could measure it, but
yeah,
let's just do it the real world way.
Real world way.
An inch in the bottom. But so it's a fair test, we will make sure they've both got identical amounts in. That's an inch, isn't it, Dave?
Losing half of mine.
That's an inch, so I'm told. You didn't get that, did you?
Oh, I thought about 8 inches in. I need a little bit more.
Yeah, a little bit more.
It's going everywhere.
Do you know what? Top tip for you. If you pour one of these 5-litre containers that way...
I know.
They breathe better,
yeah,
so you don't get that. Right.
I just love wasting product.
You can have that one, that tip, for free.
That's probably,
so would we say they're both there, level?
Are we there?
I think they're pretty much bang on, aren't they?
Yeah. So, the blue
got
peat,
any water?
Styly. Oh, so much easier.
Are we going right up to the neck?
I just go to about there with me, really. Just before the neck. Yeah.
Right.
Okay. And this is at the ready.
I reckon we do a 50-50 straight down the car.
Yeah.
So if we move the car,
yeah,
I'll do one side, you do the other.
Okay.
And we'll fight over that middle line.
Yeah.
See how we get on.
Let the viewers decide.
Yeah.
So I've not gone too thick, literally, back forth, back and forth. Don't overdo it. I don't want too much foam because you want to see it, you know, real life again, where you're not using too much of the product. Shows,
yeah,
how good it is value-wise as well.
What we've had here, probably about 2-3 minutes maybe. Still clinging well and sheeting off nice,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, it's still clinging well. Deliberately left a part there, so when I jet off, I'll jet that way and it'll give a nice comparison. It'll be easy to see how well it has cleaned, especially,
yeah,
when you do your side with the auto foam.
So we're about 6 minutes in,
yeah,
again. Definitely not as thick, this foam,
no,
is it?
No, it doesn't cling in the same. It is clinging. There's definitely not as much on there, but,
yeah,
kind of what you'd expect from a stronger, like, alkaline,
yeah,
base.
And I know foam visually looks a bit more exciting.
People love it, but I think that's a big misconception. The ones that are clinging, especially like pH neutral, where it's got, there is a bit more science in there for the reason why it clings. It's not just for,
yeah,
aesthetics. There is a purpose behind it.
Yeah.
But other
foam,
than that, you could.
The bubbles don't actually do any cleaning anyway, do they? So we don't,
no,
want to just disregard it yet just because it's not foamed as thick.
No.
But for those looking for an exciting thick foam, then they might be a little bit disappointed at first with,
yeah,
it.
Yeah, absolutely. But, yeah, let's see how it goes when we jet it off.
Let's give it a rinse. This is the Valet Pro side.
Yeah, I know you're not going to be happy because you want it touchless. But what you've got to respect, and the car's PPF, so I can get away with this, but you have, that is no longer abrasive, that is effectively a sludge. It's clinged on a little bit better, and what I was careful of as well with the pressure washer was not going too high powered to show that the, you know, the chemicals cleaning, not just,
yeah,
the pure power of the pressure washer, because,
yeah,
not
that makes
everybody
sense,
has, you know, as powerful pressure washer.
Yeah.
So I've got a sludge there now. I'm happy to do my contact wash. I've done a snow foam which has no chemicals that are really going to interfere with the LSP on this.
Yeah.
And now we'll try your side. And
so we've rinsed this one off, and instantly I'm actually...
It's cleaner. It is definitely cleaner.
I'm more impressed with this. So yeah, for me, I'm happy with this side. Both products tested. And do you know what? I thought I would go for that one out of the two, because I don't like pH 14 strong, just raw, simple products, because they're usually cheap and do the job a bit cheap and nasty, cheap and cheerful. And if I've spent a long time putting a wax coating on a car, I don't want to then just degrade it within a few washes. So I thought I would have gone for that. Actually, that, like I said at the beginning, I want a touchless wash from my snow foam. So, and that one did the trick. So I'm actually quite impressed with that. I might just dilute it further and see if I can get it a little less.
Yeah.
You know, bring that pH down.
That was a winner for me.
It's weird.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Because you're going to do a contact wash anyway. I'm not looking for that squeaky clean finish. I just want to know it's got rid of the troublesome dirt.
Yeah.
Doing my contact wash anyway. And at the, I know that my last step product is going to be absolute, as well as it can be, as we know, versus that, it will have impacted it more.
Yeah.
So I guess it depends what your approach is on cleaning.
Yeah. So if we were going to pick one or the other, I'd probably go for that. You'd go for that.
I'm going for that.
But there's also no harm in having both, I suppose. After a you know, deep, after
it
winter,
depends what
when
you
need
were going
a deep
for.
Clean.
Yeah.
That'd probably be a good one.
If you
still
want to strip back and get back to basics, you're going to be reapplying your protection, then absolutely, that is pulling more off. But maintenance, you know, in between applications, that for me is a no-brainer.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Thanks very much for watching.